Good evening, friends. Happy Sunday to all of you. The Social Security Administration has just confirmed the new average monthly payment for seniors. The new amount will be larger than expected, thanks to the new COLA adjustment. Jobless claims have dropped to new low levels. And if the economy continues to recover, lawmakers may have to make changes to Biden's crisis relief programs. Here's your fourth stimulus check update and daily news report. Please, friends, subscribe to my channel and watch until the end of this video to learn how to enter next Friday's $100 Walmart gift card giveaway. Social Security is receiving a big change this year. In fact, the largest one in almost four decades. A year of runaway inflation and surging prices in almost every major category, and specifically those affecting seniors, have forced the Social Security Administration to increase the cost of living adjustment to 5.9% for the 2022 payments. The 2022 COLA increase is one of the largest in history. To put it into perspective, COLAs of years past have hovered around 1.5%. Inflation right now currently stands at just above 6% over the past 12 months. Meaning the COLA for next year, although historically substantial, is just barely enough to wipe away the effects of this rampant inflation. According to the Social Security Administration, the estimated average monthly benefits for all retired workers will be $1,657 beginning in January 2022. Prior to the COLA taking effect, the average was $1,565, meaning seniors will receive roughly $100 more each month and $1,200 over the year as part of the COLA increase. For retired couples both receiving these benefits, the average payment will be $2,753. So friends, do you think a $2,700 check is sufficient? Please leave your thoughts in the comments section below.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Congresswoman Grace Meng, all the way from Queens, New York. I want to say a special thank you to our caucus chairman, Hakeem Jeffries, and to our small business chairwoman, Nydia Velasquez, and their teams for putting together this important event. We are here, of course, to celebrate the passage of a monumental and historical piece of legislation in the Build Back Better Act, and to implore the Senate to take up this piece of life-saving piece of legislation as soon as possible. This will make tremendous investments and transformational changes in the lives of our fellow New Yorkers and Americans all across the country. It will help so many of our working families and our kids and our senior citizens. As a mom of two young kids, helping our families and kids, this is one of the most important investments that we can make for our country. For programs like paid leave, which will help everyone from the newborn to being able to take care of our elderly, to our UPK programs that will help early education of our three-year-olds and our four-year-olds, which will be transformational in their lives. For child tax credits expansion, like Carolyn Maloney said, which will help lift so many of our kids and families out of poverty. In my district alone, in the month of October, there were about seven.
These estimates by the Social Security Administration are based on the average payment. Your specific payment could be more or less, depending on a variety of factors, like how many years you worked, your earnings, and whether or not you were married and had dependents. Several Democratic senators have teamed up to propose giving Social Security beneficiaries an extra $200 per month in the wake of this crisis and the economic devastation it has caused. The plan was put forward by Senators Elizabeth Warren, Chuck Schumer, and Ron Wyden. This move comes as some fear that many Social Security beneficiaries could be left out of the proposed bonus checks from the government. Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell has also put forward a proposal that included Social Security income. However, because a plan uses income from 2018 tax returns as a qualifier, it could leave those out who don't usually file with the IRS because their income is too low. According to Senator Elizabeth Warren, the additional money would help almost 64 million Americans who receive Social Security, and many of whom are vulnerable now because they are older. Nancy Altman, president of Social Security Works, said having extra money in their Social Security checks can help those individuals stave off extra healthcare expenses that they may face, or even help offset added costs of hiring help with grocery shopping. These are people with the lowest incomes in the country. Most of them are just above the poverty line, and so they spend the money immediately. Friends, the keyword for this video is green beans. If you would like to enter next Friday's $100 Walmart gift card giveaway, please click and like my videos, comment below the keyword from each video, and also make sure that you are subscribed to my channel. Joe Biden has also endorsed the senator's proposal. So friends, what are your thoughts on the $200 increase for Social Security beneficiaries? Please leave your thoughts in the comments section below. The number of Americans applying for unemployment benefits plummeted last week to the lowest level in more than half a century, which is another sign that the U.S. job market is rebounding rapidly from last year's crisis. Jobless claims dropped by 71,000 to 199,000, the lowest since mid-November 1969. The four-week average of claims, which smooths out weekly ups and downs, also dropped by 21,000 to just over 252,000, the lowest since mid-March 2020, when this crisis slammed the economy. Since topping 900,000 in early January, the applications have fallen steadily and now fallen below their pre-crisis level of around 220,000 a week. Claims for jobless aid are a proxy for layoffs. Until September 6, the government had supplemented state unemployment insurance programs by paying an extra payment of $300 a week and extending benefits to gig workers and to those who were out of work for 6 months or more. Including the federal programs, the number of Americans receiving some form of jobless aid peaked at more than 33 million in June 2020. So friends, thank you so much for joining me here this Sunday evening, and I hope you found some of this information helpful. If you would like to enter next Friday's $100 Walmart gift card giveaway, please click and like my videos, make sure that you are subscribed to my channel, and also comment below the keyword from each video. Thank you so much, friends, and have a very blessed weekend.